ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಚರ್ಯವೃದೀ ದಂಡೀ ಸರ್ವವೇದಾಂತ ಪಂಡಿತ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ವಿವೇದ ಯೋಗಿ ಮಾಂ ಪ್ರಚೋದಯದು ಸರ್ವದಾ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಧರೇದ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ನೋ ಎ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆತ್ಮನ್ ವಿತಿನ್. All the different religious systems in India, as also outside, are actually teaching us the various ways and means to understand or realize this Atman. Especially in India, Swamiji in one place has clarified, see, there are the three steps in this knowledge of Atman. One is Dvaita, one is Vishishtadvaita, and the last is Advaita. See, in good old days, there were always conflicts between the three. Swamiji came and harmonized everything. He says, what is that quarrel? That very famous Hanuman Stuti is there. When somebody asked Hanuman, how do you evaluate yourself in front of Lord Rama, he says, you know, in one place I am his sevaka, in another I am his friend, in another I am himself. Well, like that the steps goes. So in the same way, Swamiji says, in the early stages, when we think of the God, the early stages of our spiritual growth, when we say when we think of God means, in our early stages of spiritual growth, we cannot think of him as somebody who is residing me or I am him and all that. He is something high up above to whom I have to surrender myself, do my offerings, all that sort of thing. So he and I are sort of separate. In the second, so in this Dvaita comes most of the religions that we know are falling under this category. Swamiji says, you know, how harmonizing are his thoughts. He says, all these steps are necessary. Why do we quarrel? Say, Mohammedanism or Christianity, they are on this Dvaita stage of spiritual development. We need not quarrel about it. That religion of this step by ascent is Vedanta. So second, what is it? So in one, God is separate from me. He is somewhere high above. Secondly, the God and I have a special relationship. He is ready to bestow his kindness or grace on me. And in that way, it is Vishishtadvaita. I can reach up to him. He may come and take me to Vaikuntha. But still, I will serve him from there. He will be most compassionate. I may be given a place to sit near his feet. But still, I am separate from him. Advaita, one is complete merger. The merger of the devotee in the truth itself. A complete absorption. In the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, they say, nothing remains. You cannot feel the world outside. The salt doll gets absorbed, dissolved in the waters of the river or sea, wherever it has gone to seek the truth. That sort of complete merging. So that is what happens when Advaita, one becomes Advaitin, Advaita. There is no Dvaita Bhava at all. Sometimes when I am talking to women, I always use this example. When you are a young girl, you are so much enamored of the world outside, your beauty, your dress, your ornaments, etc. You are in a complete Dvaita Bhava. But when you get married, there is only one Lord in your life. you are getting on to the Vishishta Advaita. Almost husband and wife, we are the same. Vakartav Yavasambhrikta. Almost the same. Our ideas are same, our ideas are same. Our way of working is the same, our understanding is same. Everything is same. And in the third, then finally the motherhood dawns upon the girl. Dvaita has fallen away. Vishishta Advaita has fallen away. Even her devotion to her husband takes second place. She is completely immersed in the thought of her motherhood. Me and my child. My child is everything to me. And somebody says, you know, she is the first karma yogini. In her world, nothing but her child. All her thoughts, all her words, all her actions, everything is centered on the child. There is no other thought at all. So that was a complete absorption. Advaita. That is what makes a woman ascend to the pinnacle of Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, everything. She doesn't have to go through these difficult steps at all. She can straight away, by expanding the vision of her motherhood to some extent, a universal dimension, she can straight away climb the steps of Advaita. Nobody is there. No policeman, no Rajyogi is necessary. She can straight away climb to the pinnacle of glory. Advaita Vrithavarshini Bhagavati Ashtadashadhyayini Bhagavad Gita. Why do we call him Advaita Amrita Varshi? The result she gives is that of Advaita. No duality at all. So, Dvaita, Vishishta Advaita, Advaita. By knowing this, our mind becomes filled with a deep understanding towards all the different levels of action, levels of devotion, levels of religious or spiritual realization. We have no quarrel with anybody. Remember, Swamiji says, we not only tolerate other religions, we accept them as true. For them they are all steps in the human endeavor to reach that ultimate truth. We have no quarrel with anybody at all. So for us also, Jnana Yoga is the best medicine by which we can taste the oneness of truth, the all-pervading oneness of truth. So to that, Swamiji takes us through simple examples and simple ways of explaining. He takes us to the pinnacle of Vedanta.